to reach a wider audience and convert them to sales.
Right, good afternoon everyone. Thanks to all the participants that until lunchtime. I hope all of you have had a good lunch just now.
Yeah.
Right, so now, first of all, before we begin this particular topic, I want to find out how many of us actually over here that loves to watch movie? Can we raise up a hand? Right, great. Now, how many of you actually loves to watch drama? Drama, right? TV drama, right? And how many of us actually loves to watch online videos? Right? Inclusive of the Facebook, Instagram, and like the recent one, TikTok, isn't it? Right? Okay, now, this is the thing that we're going to share to you about, you know, as in business, right? How are we going to leverage this kind of like very engaging media as one of the tools that can really bring a lot of opportunities, exposures, not only to you yourself, but also to the business or the startup that you are going to do, right? Now, fundamentally, I also want to find out here, right? How many of you actually want to know more people to know about you and also your products? You want that? Yes, right? And how many of you actually want more people to be interested in you or your product? Yes. And of course, right, the last one, right, most important one, which is the key secret to getting sales, is actually, do you want to have more people to have confidence in you and your product? I think we do as well, right? So, okay, these are the things that we're going to cover today. How can you achieve all these three key major points, you know, in you and also your business, right? So are you ready to like to learn something here? Now, before I also move on further, I want to emphasize that a lot of times, you know, some of these informations may be available online, in articles, things like that. Some of us actually may be, you know, already aware. But do you know that the secret of learning, the secret of learning is what? It's all about you have learned something, but you unlearn it and relearn it. That is the secret of learning. And I hope this is what you're going to achieve today. Right? Learn, unlearn, and relearn. Okay? Right, sure. So now fundamentally, let's look at this. Steve Jobs, right? I think most of us, we know him. Not only himself, but also the products. I think some of us actually are using his products still, up to now. So, to him, right? And at first, we know that he's the greatest marketer of all the time, okay? To him, Steve Jobs, marketing is all about values, right? And this is what I'm going to do. In business, it's also an exchange of values. And how are we going to make sure that the values can be converse effectively across to your targeted audience, to your targeted customers, and we are going to focus on that values, right? So now, why video? Okay. There are a lot of mediums now, right now in your life, right? I'm sure that we have seen offline mediums as like TV, radio. These are offline. Then we have also print publications like magazines, articles, you know, pamphlets. It's also offline. And video, it can be categorized as both. Because on TV is on offline, but on online it's called videos, alright? Online videos. So now, why video? Let's understand a little bit about that. Before we move on to the core fundamental of why videos, right? Let's understand a little bit about statistics as well. If you look at this chart, alright? This is provided by Business Intelligence, the latest report. It actually indicated that mobile video is one of the uprising medium on this part, right? And in fact, by 2020, it's going to be one of the largest media that's going to take up at least 30 exabytes of consumption, okay? And according to Cisco, right? Cisco is one of the world number one telecom company as well. And up to 2022, you see that more than 70% of the consumption is going to be coming from mobile video as well. I think this one we don't have to deny, because basically, in our life right now, right, many of us actually has a smartphone, isn't it, right? Maybe our first has a mobile phone. And the moment we turn on to social media, most of the time, we'll be seeing videos. And you know that how videos are so engaging that you can like watch one after another one. And of course, this is not done by you intentionally. It's done by the platform themselves. They intentionally let you keep on being, you know, keep on watching and watching and watching so that they can knock you down in that particular platform. This has been done by every single social media platform, right? And that's the reason why you're seeing this increment. So now, if you're seeing these high consumptions, you know, there's so many eyes, and this is the time we call this as an eyeball economy, where how can you get eyeball attention towards you, as well towards your businesses, right? So I'm going to share a little bit how we want to do that. Okay? 9 reasons why video is better than any other medium. Okay, let's do a little bit comparison. Now, first of all, video is very unique because what? It displays non-verbal communication, right? We know that in order to do effective communications, some part of it actually comes from non-verbal. And video is capable of doing that, right? It can also provide your facial expressions, your tone of voice, movement, appearance, eye contact, gestures, postures, and so much of movement that can actually attract eyeballs, right? That's why video is important, okay? Secondly, video engages audience. Now, when we want to learn something, right, we know that, you know, people cannot remember 20% of what they hear. But the moment they can only see, they only remember about 50%. But if you combine both the visual and also audio together as one of the elements, they'll be able to remember 70%, right? Of course, there's also another school of thought that mentioned that if you do it practically, you can even remember it better as well, right? Okay? So, but in terms of videos, that is the power of it. It can ensure people be able to remember about you, your business, your branding, your products, and your solutions, right? Through this video, better, more effective than others. Now, the third one is that video comprises of all the other mediums. We know that if you look at publications, for example, magazines, articles, right? It can mostly consist of photos, graphics. But do you know that video also can include photos, graphics, and text as well, audio, right? So it is one of the mediums that can actually encompass a lot of other mediums that's not possible to be done by others. Okay. By the way, take note some of this, yeah, because why? After this, we're going to have another couple of sessions as well, and we'll prepare some gifts, and as well and another exciting announcement, which is only available to Vista participants only.
Okay.
Now, the next point, number 4, is that video is going to prompt shares. It's not an easily shared medium, right? Do you know that once it engaged you, right, it touched your heart, it connects with the values that you have in you, right? You feel that there's an obligation that you should share it more, right? If you want something that's so touching and so meaningful, it has a corporate social responsibility, you feel that it connects with my values, right? And thus, I feel that I'm obliged to share it so that more people be able to be aware about it. So that's why video actually promotes and prompts shares. In fact, nowadays, every single social media platform there, right, has a share button, right? I don't think you cannot find any platform that doesn't have a share button. No? Okay. Now, video presents quick and rich content. Now, this is a very unique comparison. Do you know that nowadays, right, us, not only Malaysians, but the global worldwide audience, we have a short span of memory. Do you know that? And this is a statistic provided in a captured in the year 2015, right? The average attention span of a people is actually 8.25 seconds. And compared to in 2000, right, it was longer, 12 seconds, right? But if you look at down there, you know, the highlighted yellow one, the attention span of goldfish in 9 seconds, which means if you feed a goldfish something right now, 9 seconds later, the goldfish actually forgotten that he has actually eaten something. So you feed, you continue to eat again. So, but human-wise, right, as I said in 2015, right, our attention is 8.25. And you know in 2018, what's the statistic? Do you know that? The answer is easily available if you observe it enough. If you look at YouTube and Instagram, right, there's this thing called the 6-second ad, 6-second advertisement. And that's the reason why our attention span is only down to 6 seconds. Right? So it's very important. In videos, right, you can actually present some quick and rich content if you know how. That's why if you look at a lot of videos, you know, why do we spend time looking through content to watch? Or whether do we skip over certain videos? It's because of the first 6 seconds. whether does it capture your attention, whether does it able to engage you, it's very important. So if you know this trick very well, right, you use video well, you know how to capture your audience attention. And the fundamental formula is about what they care about, not what you care about. It's all about audience. What do they want to know? What is the core value, right? What is important to them? It's not about your brand. And then they're willing to listen to you. Once you let them know that you care about them, you want to solve their problem, they will want to care about you. See? So that's very important. So you know how to utilize your first 6 seconds, right, in the video. Now, next one also, very important, which is video insight sections. Other than the share function that you mentioned just now, right, you also can trigger so many other actions that, for example, download some reports that you generated, download some information, subscribe to your newsletter, right, visit your website, even contact you, like watch more videos, learn more, like or share more. Even you can even do one very strong thing, which is if you are offering product services, you can even incite them to buy from you. That's the power. Of course, there's a chronology steps in order how people you want to engage them to watch you, to be interested with you, and subsequently to trust you so that they pay you on the spot. And this is something that we actually do a lot towards our client's project. Now, video enable convenient and accessible productions. We know this guy, right? I'm not sure whether how many of you have seen him before. He's a very famous vlogger. His name is called Casey Neistat. Alright? He's one of the number one vlogger in the world right now with a total of 10 million subscribers. Not 10 million views, 10 million subscribers. And what does he do? He just shares about his experience with using gadgets and devices. That's all. In fact, that's how he started off. And just to share with you, right? When he started those early days, he was just using a very basic iPhone as one of his fundamental camera to speak. So you see, with this kind of results that you see right now, like, it is very much possible for us to actually publish any medias, I mean using video as one of the medium, right, to be recognized out there. Not only locally, but also globally. It's all can be done, okay? And to be frank with you right now, we are very lucky as well, because why? The technological advancement has advanced so much that we actually have a very powerful device, a very powerful production device. We call it a video production device in your pocket right now. In the past, people say that, oh, we are carrying a photographic camera right now, but to us in the industry, we are seeing and we are observing, the camera phone is way better, sometimes even way better than some of the cameras that we're using right here. For example, the camera that you see over there, if you look at the back, you see that Kai wave his hand, right? So that is a very high-end, semi-professional camera that actually costs about 20,000. And do you know that the pocket phone that you have right now is almost equivalent to that standard, seriously, in terms of picture quality and video quality and audio quality. That's right, right? So you really have a good tool. It's just a matter of how do you want to make it properly in order to get that attention, right? Now, next, very important as well, video provides the best search engine result. Do you know that what is the number one search engine in the world? Google, right? Okay, number two search engine in the world? Number two search engine in the world, do you know what is that? YouTube. And YouTube is owned by Google. So what does that mean? So Google will definitely help YouTube searches, right? And that's the reason why, why a lot of times if you do any search online using Google on certain topics or certain products, right, you will see them featuring videos already. And this is the advantage I want to tell you, seriously. If you're in a product solutions or service solutions, right, that's very niche, and your competitor do not do any particular video yet, do it right now. Be it a simple motion graphic, be it just you looking at a video, doesn't matter. The most importantly is the title itself. The title of the video, if you put it correctly into YouTube, it will enable YouTube to find you first and send the link over to Google. So that whoever search the topic will be able to find you. And this is a trick that how we actually help a lot of corporate businesses in Johor Bahru, right, to win their competitive throughout whole Malaysia. Seriously. We have served up to now 350 corporate clients, including BMW, Toyota, Sari Properties, and this is the exact same trick that we use again and again. to help them. Right? So if this has been proven applied on those corporates and those small, medium and enterprise, you can do it as well. Right? Take note of that. The most important is the keywords. Right? So as this case you see, right? This is an example whereby, you know, if you're looking for business systemization process or some software, right? And some of it, some person actually did that video and actually found out number two, way higher than any other competitor. Be it your competitor website has already existed for more than 10 years, 20 years, it doesn't matter. Because what, as long as they don't have a video in YouTube, you're in the game. Right? So that's why there's this saying which I love a lot now. In the olden days, right, about 10 to 15 years ago, a lot of people would say, it is a matter of big fish eating small fish. Means what? Means it is only those corporate big capital spending that can actually win the marketing game. But nowadays it's no longer. It's all about fast fish eating slow fish. So it's a matter of who can do faster right now. Be it your competitors are big corporates in your niche area, it doesn't matter. As long as you come up with a video first, you're the winner. Right? Okay, are you okay so far up to now? Right, good, following me? Okay, we have more to go. Right, last one. Video enables us to reach the widest market, yeah? I think I already showed that just now. This is a statistic data. Don't deny we cannot run away from data as well, you know, you want to do things. We can, as a startup, as a business owner, we can be so emotional. We can be like using some accents, right, to drive the way we work business, but we can't run away from using data or statistics, right? And statistics proven that it can enable us to have visions of what's to come, okay? So now, okay, I think we have ended this first part of the module. Now, after we understand the power of the video, right, how do we want to leverage this power? Right, it's a very powerful medium, agree?
Agree, right?
Yeah, so how can we do it, and what are the various ways to generate a video? Like I said, you know, you really have a good production device in your hand right now, right? How can we do it? Now, first of all, the most fundamental, right, is if you're offering a product or a service, it is good to have a product or service video, which in our industry is called as commercial, right, or advertisement video, right? You enable people to understand about what your product or service does. Okay, like for example, over here you see that iWatch, right? With the launch, you know, they show you all the features, right? What the functions, what the capabilities, okay? Now, the second type is about brand or corporate videos. If there's certain core values of your business that you're going to drive up and deliver over to your audience, right, then this will be the most suitable one. It will introduce your brand to your potential customers, and it's very important. You see, a lot of product and commercials, right, actually short of some confidence element in it. It's only showcasing the product. But how do you want to give that kind of confidence to your client? It's actually through this, the branding story. What is your core value of your business? What is the core value of the principal, the founder themselves, right? And by connecting that to the human level, you know, you'll be able to strike the right chord with your audience and make them trust you. Now, there are also many other alternative effective videos also, okay? And some of these, like for example, these are the more recent ones that we see in 2018 and 2019. These are the so-called very popular medium. It's very easy to be done. For example, company culture meet the team video. In fact, with just this phone, right, you can actually go around your office, you know, introducing one by one team members. It's great because they are able to show, you know, their enthusiasm, their energy, their spirit, things like that, and it actually carry across to audience a lot. Now, second is about behind the scenes for the making. Now, this is something also very unique. In the past, right, we have been so accustomed to everything must be well planned, to be so flashy, you know. But nowadays, you know that people actually don't believe that. People feel that all this has been already pre-arranged. So, how do you want to show them the reality? It's been actually behind the scenes. If you are making the product, you can actually show them, you know, the making process. If you are doing some services, you can show them how you actually serve your clients, how you provide that solutions to them. Okay, so it's behind the scenes. That's why you see Hollywood, right? Do you know that for the past 5 years, you know, one of the best marketing approach Hollywood ever used is, they call it the BTS, behind the scene. Right? They show you how they make the movie. By looking at how they make the movie, you fully appreciate, you know, all the energy, all the effort they put inside to make that movie. And just imagine, spending that 20 ringgit is no longer a matter anymore. Why? Because you can see all the efforts by all these hundreds and thousands of professionals, you know, combine the effort together. The cost is that 30 million, 30 million just to cost a movie, right? Just to produce a movie. And you see behind the scenes all the things, all the horrible things that the actor have to go through in order to deliver that good movie to you. And that's why you don't care about that 20 or 30 million anymore. Right? It's about the value. Okay? Now, next one is about very simple interview videos. I think any one of us actually can do it. Interview videos as in user testimonial. And I tell you what, in a lot of corporate videos and commercials, right, this is the strongest element that actually help our client to secure the deal. Seriously, I'm not joking. We have just recently helped a client that's actually providing ERP resources, right? Energy resource planning resources, which is very high-end, sophisticated software. And it costs easily 6 digits to 7 digits. Seriously, per product, per client, 6 digits to 7 digits, which is even more expensive than any university's car or board. And it's all intangible. Intangible means you cannot touch, cannot feel it. And you cannot touch, you cannot feel it physically, right? What you can only is that look at the system or use it only, right? And we help them to secure just by doing 3 interviews of their satisfied client. That's all. So forget about being very flashy, going to travel throughout the whole country, capture their entire operation, and in the end the video because it is 100,000 to 200,000. A simple video which usually costs them about 3 to 4 digits on it and help them to secure that. So it is the testimonial, the human value when they speak up to themselves, right? That actually attracted the audiences and give them the confidence. Now of course, the other one would be vlog, right? I think it's a very popular medium, you know, that's been used by a lot of youngsters, of course, right? Because vlog is almost like a diary, right? You share about your life happenings, you share about your life journeys, things like that, okay? But of course, it requires a lot of discipline. It's not play. Vlog requires discipline. If you're just for the fun, for the sake of like doing 1 or 2 episodes just for fun, it won't carry much weight, it won't carry much momentum. It requires a lot of patience, a lot of discipline to do it continuously. In fact, continuous in such a way that it must be regular at a particular time, at a particular date. For example, if you were to release it on every Friday evening, make sure you do so. Else you'll be losing the attention of your followers, right? So vlog is a very powerful one as well. Now, next one will be how to use or explain them. I think we have seen a lot of this as well, especially like, I don't know if, let's say we have any mommies or daddies over here, right? Do we have mommies and daddies over here? No? Wow. Oh, we do. Okay, we do at least one, right? So, two. Okay. Now, have you ever seen your child watching Ryan Toys Review? In fact, those that they are not daddies, mommy, have you? Do you know about Ryan Toys Review? Right? It's a very popular channel, you know. So, it is actually a very technical marketing way for manufacturers or even for toys producer. In such a way, all Ryan did, right? He's not doing any commercial. He's not showing you the advertisement of the product at the time. He just let you see how he played with it. Seriously, that's all. You look at it again, you know. It's about we watch him, how he played. And that's the one that actually gave them the most attention, right? So that's also very powerful. Now the third one, the sixth one is the third party product review. And of course, number seven, the Q&A. Also very unique. If you see recently, there'll be 2 people sitting across each other, asking questions and answers. And this is also some of the productions that we've done recently, whereby we actually help businesses around in Johor Bahru to be exposed out through Q&A sessions. And I'm one of the hosts of this series as well over here. Okay? Alright, so these are the alternative effective video. Are we following up to now? It's not easy, I think, you know, after we have meal, lunch after that, you know, and I'm given these slots, right, to carry on, you know, with this entire business sessions, okay? So I need your participants as well. And subsequently, I think, if you really follow me along, I'm sure that you are going to get a couple sessions easily, okay? Now, next, if you know all the various ways of doing the videos, right, I've mentioned it so easily, then how do you reach a wider audience, okay? How can we do that? There are actually 4 important tips if you want to do that. Okay? Now, number one, it's all about keeping your storytelling interesting. Okay? Like what I said, it is not about you being interesting. It is about you being interested. Can you get the difference here? I hope you all, you know, look at these two statements deeply. Be interesting and be interested is totally different. Be interesting means, hey, I've got a very good product here, you know, it's the best in market. That's called be interesting. That means you try to be interesting. But the trick or the most effective way to gain your audience attention, right, is that be interested in them. It's like, what do you want? Do you, as a parent, wish to see your child growing happily and healthily? Right? That's the way you gain their attention first, you know? You tell them that you care about them. You know what they want. They want to listen to you. Get it? I have mentioned this just now, right, earlier on my, you know, in my opening sessions, right? Okay? Therefore, you need to craft a very compelling story, and it's not hard. You always go back to fundamental. Look, people make it too hard. Oh no, I've got to plan the script, I have to plan the storyboard, things like that. No, you don't need to. Go back to the fundamental. Think through about what your customer wants, your targeted customer wants. Talk to them in their way. It's that easy, alright? And they'll listen to you. Now, of course, like I said, timing also very important. We cannot run away from some of the scientific method as well. You have seen our attention span is really very bad, right? 6 seconds is the most, you know, that you can capture their attention. So how can you do it in under 10 seconds? Right? So that's why it goes back to my first point, which is about be interested. As long as they feel that they're connected to you, your core value and their core value, your principal life concern is the same, they will continue to want to watch. Have you ever gone through, you know, some Facebook video scrolling, right? That you keep on scrolling, scrolling, and there's something called, we call it the thumbnail stopper. Thumbnail stopper is like, there's something that attracts you to continue to watch first. And you stop it, and you continue to watch. If it doesn't strike your core, you continue to scroll, right? And that's the why. Because some of them actually know how to capture attention in the first 10 seconds. If they do not, you will lose attention, you move on, right? Okay, now, after watching your video, right, it doesn't mean anything if you don't incite them for any action, seriously. You don't want your audiences to watch your video just to, oh, okay, now I know it, and that's it. You don't want them to do so. You want them to do something, right? That's why I mentioned earlier, my first thing is that it can video enable you to add actions in it. And you see all this, right, you can actually, you know, put it to your websites, your social media, things like that, to trigger. Even though you don't have the button, doesn't matter. You can easily use link, you know, click here, click the link, right? You'll bring that to your shopping cart, it can bring you to your website, to your social media, things like that. You want to lock them down, you want them to do actions. Or the most simpler one, I'm also sure that some of you may have done some Facebook posting before. And do you notice that whenever we do any Facebook posting, right, a lot of people will actually be interested, they will actually start to PM, PM, PM. Do you see that? Very often, right? And you know that in order to get one of the most effective way of securing them, it's actually not through PM. PM is one of the lousiest way, because why? A lot of people actually just ask for fun. And the first thing they open their mouth, when they PM you, know what they ask? What's the price? Right? Isn't it true? Agree? So, in order how to prevent that, there's also another simple trick. Just create a simple Google form. Right? I think all of us actually know how to create a Google form. And all you need to do, just ask them for their name, phone, or email address, that's all. People, they're actually just asking for fun, they'll never do so, seriously. At least half of them will be filtered away. And only those people that are really serious into like understanding, wanted to know more about you, or even your services, or your products, right? They'll give you their name, and so forth. So that's also one of the simplest tricks that you can ever apply to your, this video's call to action, okay? Now, what matters next is that where you want to share your video. You cannot be like just simply dumping to any place that doesn't not relevant at all. For example, we know that, okay, Instagram. Instagram are mostly youngsters, right? Those Gen X, Y, Z, you know, right? And it's no fault if I were to say Instagram is more inclined to female, correct? More inclined to female, right? So just imagine if in Instagram, you are, for example, you're selling medicine for old folks. Do you think that by producing a video or like doing an advertisement and put it to Instagram, will work the best for you? It will not, because your audience is not there, right? So that's why a lot of people, my client also till now will ask me, Ken, I don't think that the TV, you know, or channels like that will work anymore. I said, no, no, no. It works. If you're serving senior citizens, seriously. A lot of senior citizens still watch TVs, right? So it works very best if you are selling senior citizens product, right? So these are all the social media platforms that's available. Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, YouTube, LinkedIn, Instagram, and also Google Plus, right? And let me ask you a very simple question. If it's for business, right? Business community, if you're targeting your socials to C-suite kind of level, director level, manager level, where would you want to go?
LinkedIn.
Yeah, correct. Good job. Good job on answering that. LinkedIn is the one, seriously. And it's one of the most underutilized platform ever in Malaysia. Because why? A lot of Malaysian companies still did not realize the powerful potential. So if your competitors does not have a presence there right now, and if you are doing business solutions, go and strike at them right now. Establish yourself there right now, okay? So fundamentally, you have to make sure that the platform that you share, you truly make sense. And it also matters a lot if you are sharing to the right influencer. Okay, influencer doesn't mean that the kind of, you know, super famous girl or guy, things like that, not necessary. Influencer means someone that can actually have the power to persuade others to watch or to share that element as well. For example, if let's say we talk about in Malaysia, right? You have this E3 Park committee, you have startup committee. If you are able to get Andrew Wong's attention to your video, and the moment he shared it, I guarantee you will be thousands or even up to 5-digit business owner will be able to see that. That's so powerful, right? So get the right place, right time, right platform, and also right people to share it on behalf of you. Okay? Oops. Alright now. Questions? You already come to the end of the sessions right now. How can I help you? Is there any questions that you'd like to ask further? Before I show you anything? Up to this moment? If not, I'll be available at the back right after this. And if you want to also sorry. Yeah. Okay, good questions. Then your name? Yichuan. Okay, it's a very fantastic question, sir. Alright. Now, how do you prevent people from copying your idea, right? Okay, now. One thing for sure, we have to know, we are all business startups or business owners here. I think a lot of times we have gone through certain situations whereby we have thought about something, we have some idea in our mind. But after a while, if you don't take any action on it, right, you see someone else did it already. Agree? I'm sure some of you, I was the one that thought about it first and now I'm seeing other people. So I want to tell you one thing, you know. Idea can be generated by anyone, seriously. Idea, in another way, idea is cheap, right? But it is the action that matters the most. So don't care, right? Each one, I just want to answer you. Don't bother. Don't think too much of whether people are going to copy your idea or not. Like what I said just now, it's about fast fish eating slow fish. It's a matter of who takes the action first, is it? In the current world, and you win the competition. So don't bother too much, yeah? Alright, just go ahead. Of course, I also understand that some of you, what if other people can download my video, copy it, you know? There are a lot of ways. We need to let them copy, you know? Of course, the best way, right, you put a watermark there, which is easily available in your phone as well. Your phone, right, I'm sure that be it Samsung, Huawei, you know, Oppo, or even iPhone, right, you have a simple video editor that you can actually add your logo there, or your name there easily, right? So, yeah, that's one way to prevent. So, did I answer you? Alright, thank you. Okay, thank you, John. Any other questions? Remember, we are here to learn, unlearn, and relearn. And this is a session, time for you to do so, alright? Okay, so if not, then we move on to the next one. Now, okay, only for today, for these Vstart participants, our company is actually offering a free class only for 10 packs. Right, only for today, in terms of how to hook any audience and capture their attention. And in these sessions, I'm going to share with you about the 6 basic emotions of human. And how can you use video to tap on that 6 emotion in such a way that they'll fully trust you and they'll come to you and say, hey, take my money. Right? So I'm going to do that. So after this, you can see me at the back. I'll be doing that registration with me straight on my... I have a huge form to fill only for 10 packs, yeah? Alright, and we'll be conducting this in the next one, in the month of August. Alright? Okay, so I think that's all. Now, one thing is that I wanted to share, just mention this again, yeah. You all can actually dream big, you know. But somehow, right, in order to be successful, you all can start small. And for video productions, I seriously tell you all, you all can start small. Don't think too much, just produce. Be it at the end of the day, be it like today or tomorrow, right, if you find that, you know, you have that urge to do so, don't wait. Pick up your phone from pocket and do that recording straight away. Alright? Okay, thank you everyone.
Congratulations, go